As these public hearings finally get underway, I hope we can now move more quickly to determine the truth, assign responsibility for what happened, and then put this matter behind us. The American people deserve no less. Because of the seriousness...
His was a political career started on a whim when he threw his hat in the ring for a seat in the Michigan House of Representatives in 1947. William Broomfield said he just wanted to see how many votes he could get. He won the Republican primary by a scant 80 votes and went on to win the general election in November. At 26 years of age, Mr. Broomfield's career was in motion. He served in the Michigan State Senate in 1955 and 1956. Then, in November of 56, he overcame the star power of his opponent, Paul Sutton, to win the election for U.S. House of Representatives. Sutton, who was the familiar voice of Sergeant Preston of the Yukon and a national radio star, was the better-known candidate, but Broomfield was the better candidate. His honest answers and forthright demeanor won the trust and the votes of the people. In his early years as a congressman, he served on the House Public Works Committee. During the Kennedy administration, he served as the ranking Republican on the Subcommittee on Asian Affairs. In 1960, he was appointed to the House Foreign Affairs Committee, where he remained until 1992, and becoming the ranking member in 1975. In 1967, President Johnson appointed Bill as the U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations. Under Jimmy Carter, he found himself at the center of the Camp David Accords, working directly with Egyptian President Anwar Sadat and Israeli Prime Minister Menachem Begin. During the Cold War, he was appointed by Carter to serve as a member of the congressional delegation to the Strategic Arms Limitation Talks. He is best known for his level-headed thinking, his decency and honor, his sense of humor, and his bipartisan cooperation.
He was about bringing people together. Right now, we've got a political environment that is very partisan and is very difficult to bring a consensus. But Bill Broomfield was always a consensus builder. That is how he approached politics, and the lessons that he can bring us about what he has done over his 36 years are very important today as we face some very, very difficult issues as a country, as a state, and as a community. Bill Broomfield represents the idea that we need to come together and think about what we have in common and not what our differences are.
The pictures really tell the story. Bill Broomfield was at the center of world politics at critical times in history, meeting with world leaders, tackling international issues, while continuing to look out for the interests of the people of Michigan and his own congressional district back home. Throughout the history of the United States Congress, 10,500 Americans have served in the House of Representatives. Listed among the top 30 in seniority is Michigan Congressman Bill Broomfield. He was not a congressman involved with trivial issues or political posturing. For 36 years, we had a congressman who was instrumental in shaping the policies of our government and was involved in truly historical events: the building of the Berlin Wall, the Cuban Missile Crisis, the Vietnam War, Poland's Solidarity Movement, the collapse of the Soviet Union, Tiananmen Square, Iran-Contra, Desert Shield. Upon Mr. Broomfield's retirement, President Bush wrote this note: "It won't be the same at all without your leadership in the House, without your decency and honor. I understand your decision, indeed respect it, but I will miss your counsel and support." The man whose career began on a whim became a trusted and respected leader on issues that affected the freedom of millions. His collection of artifacts and documents from these events must be preserved and made available for future generations to study and to inspire future leaders.
I say let the chips fall where they may, but let's get on with it so that the government can return to governing effectively.